proteins behind COVID-related blood vessel damage identified by scientists. Severe vascular damage in some patients of COVID-19 is a mystery. Recently, a team of scientists found the proteins responsible for that. The discovery may help develop new targeted treatments that reduce vascular damage due to COVID. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. At Tel Aviv University, scientists finally answered the mysterious vascular damage reported in some COVID-19 cases. They explained that SARS-CoV-2, the COVID-19 virus, is relatively simple. It only has 29 different proteins, compared to the tens of thousands of proteins you can find in the human body. Published in the journal eLife, the team used the RNA of each protein of the coronavirus. To know how each would react, they inserted them into the human blood vessel cells in the lab. This was to observe the interactions between the viral proteins and the cells. The experiments were a success and uncovered crucial insights. We tend to think of COVID as primarily a respiratory disease, but the truth is that coronavirus patients are up to 3 times more likely to have a stroke or heart attack, study lead Dr. Ben Mao said, per Science Daily. Dr. Mao explained that when the coronavirus enters the body, it produces 29 proteins that form a new virus. That new virus also produces 29 proteins, and so the replication begins. Of the 29 proteins, 5 were strongly linked to blood vessel damage. During the invasion, blood vessels from their opaque state would turn into something like pieces of cloth. Although all 29 proteins could impact blood vessels, 5 of them do the greatest damage to endothelial cells, impairing the function and stability of blood vessels. The findings showed that the coronavirus is more than a respiratory pathogen. Sure, it primarily enters through the nose and attacks the respiratory system, but it can also impact other organs. When it does, a person becomes at risk of severe symptoms, especially if they aren't vaccinated yet. So, it is highly recommended to get vaccinated and follow preventive measures to keep their virus at bay. What's your take on the study findings? Do you think the findings can unlock new drugs for COVID-related vascular damage? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching. Thank you.